today we have a very special stream because I am not what one might call a historical person. I do not know history things.
He is one of the gamers of all time.
I am a gamer. I don't. If we have another world war, I won't know what happens. But luckily, with me here is Galahad Marksman of Galahad Marksman fame, and he happens to be an expert on things of historical value, especially that of a man named Galahad.
Indeed, I wouldn't say expert, but I.
The leading expert is 7 years at Harvard. To learn everything there is to know about Galahad's history. Sure.
That's yes, I spent 7 years at Harvard, actually. Mm-hmm. That is mm-hmm. true. Mm-hmm. I worked at the pizza shop next door, but it was Harvard adjacent.
Harvard adjacent. Yeah, I got a degree in Harvard area. Today we're doing... Oh, there it goes. Didn't show for a moment. We are doing a... the worst screen to see. We are doing a Galahad tier list. Now, there is a Galahad drink that I miss, but I'm going to say that these are all just Galahad adjacent. Because apparently the Galahad drink is not that good, so we don't even need to do it.
Yeah, no, no, no.
No, no, no. I'm not a drinker, but...
Drinker?
What's the joke?
I hardly know her.
Oh, right. Da-da-da-da-da. But yes, today we have a tier list of people who have either played as Sir Galahad, robots that are Galahad, anime waifus that are Galahad, or low-poly Galahad. We have everything covered. We have all the Galahads covered here.
We've covered every base.
We've covered every base has been covered. But I think before we begin, we should have a discussion of who Galahad was. And I feel like you should take the lead on this.
Who Galahad was?
Yeah.
All right. So in the King Arthur fable,
mm-hmm.
there were many knights around the round table. I did not mean for that to rhyme.
No, keep going.
Sir Galahad was the strongest and the invincible. And... So if you don't know anything about the round table, it's wild and wacky. It makes no sense. There's a lichen in there somewhere. But Galahad is famous for being invincible and having the strength of near godliness.
It's like an early anime. No, nothing made sense.
He doesn't do the do is the whole reason why.
He doesn't do the do? What do you mean by he doesn't do the do?
As long as he stays a virgin, he is invincible, and he has the strength of God and anime on his side.
Oh, he's a Chad. Okay, I get it. Well, I guess that would be a Sigma. He's a Sigma male. The most powerful males. He's got the Sigma grind set.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So what I'm hearing is, and this tier list, by the way, is not based off how likely they are to be the original Galahad. It's more of just... the respect it pays to the original Galahad story, I think, right?
It's whatever tier list you want to do.
That's true. It is my tier list. I mean, if we're going to be honest, Mighty Python then nailed it on the cross with like the bit. I remember the Galahad bit of that movie being where he's with a bunch of women who are chasing him around.
That's exactly the point. It's such a,
and they're all virgin nuns, right? Wasn't that like a whole bit? Yeah.
Oh, it is a lonely life. Bathing, dressing, undressing, making exciting underwear.
Yep, and Sir Galahad the Chaste, that's the whole point.
Gotcha, yeah. It's a pretty good bit, honestly. I like it a lot. I think we could start with Mighty Python, because I think this is the one that, like, most people recognize. I mean, weirdos recognize this one, but we'll get to him later. I know about him. I didn't even need to look this guy up. I knew about this guy.
I didn't know about that guy, but when you told me to go, okay, gather as many Galahads as you could. He's like, there's a Sonic one? I've got to put that in Cole's screen.
This was a wacky one. We'll get to him. We'll save him. But I think we can safely say the Galahad from Mighty Python is like A. Solid A. It pays solid homage. A. Well, it pays homage, you know? It doesn't do anything crazy. I mean, it makes fun of him, but, like, it's like, there you go. But that's, like, about it. I mean, you can contest it. You are more of an expert than I will be.
I just figured that with that resounding review that you gave, you would put him in S tier.
Here's the thing. I don't think he's as hot as some of the other people on this list.
Hmm.
Okay. I think that's important. I think that's got to be a very important. It's because, nothing's more attractive than a man that you can't have, you know?
Yeah, that's true.
That's a very important rule.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, okay, what do we have next here? We have Galahad from, hold on. We have Galahad from the original RuneScape.
Yes.
Which, because of the shaping of everything, it's just his torso. So it's just...
I was wondering what that was.
I wish it wasn't just his torso, but yes, it is just his torso. And looking into it, apparently Sir Galahad won the Knights of the Round Table and one of the three achievers of the Holy Grail. He now lives west of McGerber's Woods and does not mind somebody stopping by to talk to once in a while. Stating that it is a rare that this happens. During this conversation, he may give players cups of tea. Pretty nice. The religion of Saradomin.
Saradomin? Yes, I do.
Yes, Saradomin.
I was an avid player of RuneScape back in the day.
Okay, I think it's important to know that in the wiki page, it says, although he wears a holy symbol, he claims to not worship Saradomin. What does it mean by claims?
He's obviously not telling the truth. He's wearing this. He's wearing the shirt and everything.
We specifically made sure you can only see the shirt. You can see the holy symbol. So is this Galahad a little liar?
This Galahad's a little liar. Plus, you can actually kill him in the RuneScape game.
That's a D tier. Yeah, that's D. Yeah. If you can kill him, he lies. And he's like a loner. He lives out on his own. No way. No. Galahad would ever end with his life just being out in the woods. That's a terrible, terrible fucking. Be gone with you. All right. Well, let's talk about actually something not sad. Let's talk about Silver the Hedgehog. Okay.
Right.
Okay.
In his memory, we do enjoy it. Anyway, back to Hedgehog.
So, Gabe, did you ever play any of the Wii era Sonic games?
I never played any Sonic game, and I'm proud of that.
Okay, good. You're already on your way of being a good human being. The Sonic franchise during the Wii era was at a bit of a weird spot. They didn't know what games to make, and they weren't sure what the sort of formula they wanted to do was. So what they did was they made a new series of Sonic games called the Storybook Collection. I want you to guess how many Storybook Collection games they made.
I don't have any context for this, Cole.
So let me rephrase this. So the Storybook Collection basically was Sonic and his friends get trapped into like worlds of fantasy stories.
Okay.
So
I do remember seeing this in the wiki.
Yes.
Where
okay.
I was like, what the hell is this?
So there are only two of these games that exist.
Two? That's it?
There is Sonic and the Black Knight, and then which is one where he's stuck in King Arthur times. And Merlin is a girl. And then Sonic and the Secret Rings, which is when Sonic gets trapped in 1001 Arabian Nights, and you only get to meet three of the knights. And the villain of the game is called Eraser Jin, who is erasing the book as you are inside of it.
What kind of a...
You go to like famous locations from within the 1001 Arabian Nights, including Dinosaur Land. You remember when you went to the dinosaurs in 1001 Arabian Nights?
No!
Where there's a bunch of overgrown...
We're talking about 1000 Arabian Nights, you know, the actual like...
The book.
The historical...
Yeah, Sonic and his friends got stuck in the book. Well, Sonic got stuck in his book, but then all of his friends also are in the book somehow. That's the one that ends on the lines of the tissues? Okay. Yeah, that's the tissue one.
Yeah, it hurts my head.
Well, okay, so that's Secret Rings, but we're talking about Sonic and the Black Knight. Sonic and the Black Knight has less context because Sonic literally just falls from the world after Merlin summons someone that he... Like, she's like, oh, I need a hero! And then Sonic just falls from the sky eating a chili dog.
I need a hero. I need a hero starts playing in the background. I just falling out of nowhere. I need a hero.
But yeah, King Arthur is evil in this one, and he's in like a black suit of armor, and he's like corrupted, yada yada yada. But and here's when Silver comes by. Sonic's friends are now replacements of the Round Table. So I think Knuckles is Gawain. I'm pretty sure Knuckles is Gawain. No, Sir Gawain is Blaze the Cat. I'm looking up what Knuckles was, because it was Blaze, Silver, and... Oh, no, yeah, Knuckles was Sir Gawain. Then who was Blaze?
Knuckles is the red one, right?
Yes, Knuckles is the red one, and he uses two swords. Percival
was... He doesn't use his knuckles?
Well, you know, he does use his knuckles, but then, like, they gave him, like, a short swords that, like, acted like his knuckles. He still punches with the swords. He's very inefficient with his fighting style.
Okay.
And yes, Sir Gawain is Silver the Hedgehog, and Silver has psychokinetic abilities where he can lift and move things with his minds.
Okay.
And in the original game, Sonic 06, where he's from, he was unbeatable because he could lock you in a corner and kill you forever. So he can just combo you forever in the corner of a room and just you just die. So I think that makes it pretty invincible.
Hey, it's no use!
Yeah, that does make him pretty invincible.
That does make him...
That would be getting as close to the story as you can.
That would be being pretty close to the story, but it's also from Sonic and the Black Knight, a game that is not very respectful to the source material, so we're going to go ahead and put him here. I think this is... He looks cool. He's got a cool design. I'm not going to pretend it's not a cool design.
And they just put a mask on a chicken.
What are you talking... He's a hedgehog.
He does not look like a hedgehog to me.
He's a hedgehog. What do you mean he doesn't look like a hedgehog to you? He's a hedgehog.
No, they're spiky. That just looks like feathers.
Yeah, of course they're spiky. All of Sonic's friends are spiky. Oh, right. Shadow's also there, too. I forgot. How could I forget Shadow?
Oh, no. I don't even... So does that mean he's the good guy, then?
Or who? Sonic?
Shadow.
No. Shadow's also part of the Round Table.
But Shadow's always got to be, like, on the other side. Like, well, he can't be on the good guy's side, he can't be on the bad guy's side.
Well, so, yeah, they forgot about that part when making the movie. And also, Amy is a lady of the water. Lady of the lake.
Sure.
Yeah, it's great. Did I mention the fact that Merlin's a waifu?
Listen, we'll get to the Fate series when we get to the Fate series.
No, in the game, too.
I know.
You want to talk about Fate, an anime I've never gotten into?
Okay, sure. I will say though, you used one of the three photos I sent you for Fate.
Yeah.
And I'm surprised you went with this one, because it really doesn't showcase the absolute whatever the heck is going on nonsense that is Fate.
So the photos you sent me, I couldn't use because they're all .web.
Oh.
Yeah. No. You still gave me a starting point. You still gave me what I needed.
Gave you a good foundation.
Yeah.
So, in the Fate series, specifically Fate Grand Order, which is a gacha mobile game.
Already featured. Okay, hold that thought. All right, keep going.
Based around historical figures. So, you have people like you have Romulus, who founded Rome. You have Achilles. You have Edison. You have King Arthur, who was actually a woman. You have... We're gonna move on past that. You can do it.
No, I'm good.
Nikola Tesla. But,
Is Nikola Tesla a woman?
Nikola Tesla is not a woman. He is, in fact, an alien. But... Regardless of all that, when you first start the game, you get a companion who's here to help you. Her name is Mash. She is a quasi-servant, which is what these heroics people are, is servants, where she has been imbued with the power of Galahad. And so this is actually, the picture you have is actually a gender-bent version of that character, who wears high heels, battle armor similar to this, and uses the giant shield.
According to Merlin, Galahad is so selfish that he is disinterested. He sees no need for him to help humanity despite being a heroic spirit. This ultimate in purity and cleanness. In a way, he's the most heartless man that Merlin has ever met. According to Galahad Altar, Galahad had no wish off for himself and no idea what to do when he found the Holy Grail. He lived his entire life on force of habit. God, what a boring character. You get the Holy Grail and you're just like, eh, whatever, I don't care about it.
The Holy Grail being a massive magical source of energy that allows you, the user, to have a wish granted.
Yeah.
In the Fate universe.
Yeah, I know that much about the Fate universe. I know that much.
So I'm not sure if you wanted to use this Galahad or the quasi versions that I had sent you. That is what this character is. They were moved, their spirit and powers were moved into waifu version so that she could actually have a personality. And that personality is, I want to help my friends and I love the MC.
Oh, they made a new... Oh, I see. Okay.
Yeah.
So they took the really boring Galahad and then made him better by making him a girl who helps.
Yes.
Okay. Well, then I think it's safe to keep him here then, right?
I mean, if you'd like, yes.
I mean, he doesn't seem pretty invincible. He seems pretty boring of a character, honestly.
A little bit boring, yeah. Yeah. There's so many different variations of characters to use in that game, and it's sad that someone that I like is portrayed as this.
We got the Order 1886.
This was a game.
It was a game that came out, and everyone just kind of went, oh.
So this game was really cool. It was just... When it came out, it was really cool because it was the first one that was like super immersive and the high tech graphics and all that.
Right.
But they filled it with nothing. Like there was all this stuff that you could go and inspect and you could, your character, like in Red Dead Redemption 2 style,
mm-hmm.
you could turn the papers over, you could look over everything, like, you know, really inspect it all. But let's say you don't care about that.
Mm-hmm.
Just for a second. You don't care about the finer details of the game.
I don't care about anything.
You care about the gameplay.
Right.
So you play the game. And 4 hours later, you're done with the game.
And now you're like, wait.
And you're like, ah, there's gotta be like missions, extra missions or something. It's like, no, that's it.
That's it. We're done.
But that's just the game portion.
It was one of the first releases for the PS5, right?
Four,
really? Four. Oh my god. I feel old already, Jesus. It's one of those like what games that came out to show the power of the console.
Yes.
So unfortunately, it's just one of those things where, you know, people watched it and played it and then they're like, oh, that's it. All right, we'll move on. I'm looking at the fandom wiki and there's barely anything besides the legend of this character.
Yes, so in this universe, Nikola Tesla is actually in it, so we're bringing
Wait, hold on. Nikola, are they a girl in this one?
No, they are not a girl in this
okay,
one.
Okay, I gotta double check, okay?
Ever since the Fate debacle, you gotta check everything. So in this one, the original Knights of the Round Table find the Holy Grail. And they use it to create Black Blood or something along those lines. I can't quite remember it.
Okay.
But it gives them immortality. This Galahad is the first Galahad.
Oh, okay.
He's just lived all the way into Victorian England times.
Gotcha. That's why I kept saying that he was so jaded. Let's get worried for a second.
Yeah, so because of the Black Blood or something along those lines, something is wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Lycanthropy is rampant in England. Werewolves of London.
Gotcha. I remember that.
Yes, he is part of the task force that deals with them. So that's the basis for the story, which automatically puts it at a lower tier for me because he's British.
Oh, he is British. Also, yes. We have another situation here where this Galahad's jaded again.
Yes.
Also, apparently from what I'm reading of how he plays, he's supposed to play very much like a... expert tracker and hunter whose instincts and skills developed over the years fighting half-breeds are legendary among the members of the Order. They numb to the violence he witnessed day to day. Galahad is a world weary with a calm, cool, professional demeanor. That means nothing. That means he doesn't have a personality. His personality is, oh, I know what I'm doing. I'm so cool.
He's got an internal monologue, and that internal monologue is the player being like, what am I doing right now?
Exactly, exactly. I'm assuming each of these characters play differently, right?
What do you mean?
Like, each character that's in this game, the order, you can play as all the characters from the order, right? Or are you playing your own character?
You play Galahad.
You play this guy?
You play Galahad.
Oh, he's the character you play as? Cringe.
He's the character. That's why I said, it's like, his internal monologue is just you.
Oh, okay. All right, well then, yeah, it's down here you go. We do not like Galahad to be sad and depressing. These two are perfect for each other. I want to put this one higher. At least he wants to talk to people. You know, executive decision. This is going to hire just because he wants to talk to people. At least he's happy when people show up. If you walked up to these two, they both just go like, oh, whatever.
Like, especially in the legend of the absolute Chad that is Galahad, that's not what you're looking at. You don't want someone who doesn't care about. You don't want the emo boy with silver hair and purple clothes. You don't want the stoic type that doesn't talk about anything except for maybe the crumpet that he found on the table 2 days ago. You want the heroic.
You want heroic. All right, enough about werewolves. Let's talk about robots.
It's the best and the worst. Okay, so robots. Mm-hmm. This is from the anime Code Geass.
Is it like Gundam? Is it like a Gundam thing?
It is a mech one. I wouldn't say it's Gundam. It's definitely not Gundam. In this universe, Britannia.
Mm-hmm.
Is the reigning country, which is
Britannia?
Washington's rebellion, as it's referred to, was squashed.
Oh, okay. So
and then France invaded Britain, and so the royal family moved to modern-day United States, became Britannia, and just started taking over everything.
So this is another British thing, right?
It is another British thing.
And okay, hold that thought.
There you go. This is again. This is the Galahad, which is one of the royal, quote-unquote, knights of the royal family.
I will say it's got a kind of a cool sword.
Yes. That is one of the draws of this, is like, there's the intrigue and psychological drama going on with the characters, but, you know, you're not there for the psychological drama with the characters. You don't give a crap about that. You want to see the giant robots fight.
Well, so I'm looking at this character design. I'm already having a few problems. One, Galahad is supposed to be indestructible. I don't see a shield in this guy anywhere.
It is a mech.
It is a mech.
Shields are like the weird, like, plated shields. Like, oh, I've taken damage. My shields are down to 30%.
But I mean, there are, like, actual mechs that have, like, a shield built up to them, right? I'm not crazy.
Yes, there are. You're not crazy about that at all.
But here's the other problem. The Galahad is destroyed by Suzaka's Lancelot Albion.
Yes, it is.
So, see what I mean? He was sliced in half with the Excalibur.
Hey, he's a Galahad. I didn't say he was perfect, and I didn't say he was traditional.
Yeah, well, he is salvaged. So I guess he isn't dead. He still lives on. He was salvaged for the Tristan Divider. Let me see what this thing looks like. Oh, that's disgusting. That's an ugly robot. What the fuck? What the hell happened?
Yeah.
What? I'm sending it to you.
Hi.
Do you know the robot?
I mean, yes, I do know the robot. I've seen the entire series. That's why I knew to add it to this list.
Yeah, are you kidding me? This is what happens to him? I'll put it on.
That's what they do.
I'll put it in the VOD. But yeah, that's, no, I mean, ugh. Man, this D tier is full. That's so sad.
You were hoping at least there would be more.
Yeah, I was hoping this would at least be a B tier. Yeah. Well, this just sucks.
Yeah.
Well, that sucks for the robots. Man, Code Geass, I'm never going to watch Code Geass now at this point.
I mean, you have to, though. That's part of the deal, isn't it? It's part of the deal.
Nah. All right, we got one last Galahad. Who is this, though? Who could this be?
This is Chimkin.
Oh. Hold on. Oh, no, I don't.
Immediately D tier, huh?
But I can't. Right, I can't move you anywhere else. I can't put you. I can't. Here, I'll put you next to Silver the Hedgehog for right now.
Okay. That's me. That's Galahad Marksman. That's me playing Destiny, and that's Chimkin.
Whoa! You play Destiny? When do you play Destiny?
I play Destiny Mondays, I play Destiny Wednesdays, and I play Destiny Saturdays.
So literally the days that I'm streaming.
Yes, and I typically try and raid your streams.
Yes.
With those people. So.
Well, if you all want to see him, you guys can go to Galahad Marksman on twitch.com, which will be in the link in the description. I will say I've seen you play. You play as a defender. You usually never die, and when you do, you respawn. So that's not really dying, you know.
No, I am technically immortal.
So we're gonna go ahead and put you right up there with Harry. There you go.
I know. I'm assuming that the only reason that that picture is out there is because of chicken.
Oh, it's also the only image I can get of you.
Yes, but of course, like I would probably be in like A or B tier. But I appreciate you putting me up there. So
I think the chicken is what really sells it. I mean, the chicken's actually the one that's up there. You're just kind of holding the chicken.
Yes.
Well, thank you, Galahad, for joining the stream and for joining me on this wonderful Tier List Tuesday.
It was my pleasure. Can I get a final free pack? I haven't gotten a single hashtag free pack. Can I get one hashtag free pack from
That's
anybody?
YouTube comments, hashtag free pack. Fill it. Fill it all. I want my DMs to be filled with hashtag free pack.
Meet me in my DMs.
Oh, fuck. All right. Have a good night, everybody. Goodbye, everybody.
Good night.